Nomadic Bedouin tribes dominated the Arabian Peninsula. Nomadic pastoralists who relied on herds of goats, camel, sheep for meat, milk, fur wool, etc. Let us discuss the socio-economic condition before the birth of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ignorance. There was no much importance for literacy. In the whole Arabian Peninsula, there were only few people who knew how to read or write. Barbarism. There were many tribes in the Arabian Peninsula, and they used to fight years and years with each other on a very small and minor issues. Some of them, Aus, Khazraj, Banu Qurayza, and other tribes. Usually, exploitation. The poor and needy people, they used to take loan on interest and spend their whole life to repay. And the merchant and rich people, they used to exploit those needy and poor people by giving them loan on interest. Discrimination of caste and color. They were proud of themselves. They used to call them Arab and the other people Ajam, means dumb. Fear and terror. There was no safety and security in the society for people. Lost the true concept of God. They placed idols inside the haram, inside the house of Allah, and start worshipping idol instead of worshipping the true God. Love and brotherhood. People were discriminated on the basis of caste, color, creed. Now they all become brother. There was no preference based on the color, caste, or tribe. They're all human beings, they all become one. Peace and security. We have come to know from the life of the Prophet Muhammad that after his prophethood, the society has become a most peaceful society. A man could leave his house open, or a woman can wear all their golds and she can travel alone. There was no fear of being robbed. Last but the most important, restoration of the true concept of God. The Arab people lost the true concept of God. They were worshipping idols. In fact, they placed the idols inside the Kaaba and they start worshipping them instead of Allah Almighty. So he restored the true concept of God, that he is God, the one and only. He begets not, nor is begotten. There is nothing like unto him. The characteristics of the new era. Laws and values from heaven, not earth. Way of life as per divine guidance, not human desire. Long term, not short term. Permanent guidance and solution, not temporary. Addressing all human beings, rich and poor, black and white. Addressing all aspects of life for the entire world, not a region or country. Guidance from the Creator, who knows man unlike others.